Are you serious, Fresh Coffee, this morning? Are you serious? Something biblical. Something definitely biblical is going on all over the world. But I'm going to start with the first story. 30,000 dead sheep in Uruguay. What? Hosea prophecy being fulfilled again because of man's sin. First of all, I want to say this. In Uruguay, back on April the 26th, for the first time in history, there were fluorescent, glowing lambs born by scientists in Uruguay. Lambs that were born that glowed, okay, doing some genetic altering. I know this isn't a good thing to do. I know this isn't even right. But it happened. It was posted back on April the 26th of this year, 2013. Well, now there's been a significant development. I'm going to show you a picture. As 30,000 sheep have died in 3 days in the nation of Uruguay due to a tremendous 3 days of rain, temperature change, and storms. 30,000 lambs, 30,000 dead sheep in Uruguay. What? Yes, and here's what they're saying happened. And then let me give you a scripture. I want to thank James McKay for this information. But a storm carrying heavy rainfall, lethal winds, and drastic temperature swings in Uruguay back on September the 19th of this year, 2013, in the course of three days it lasted, the storm managed to take the lives of more than 30,000 of the country's sheep. The storm, which was particularly damaged for the country's north and northwest regions, where much of the Uruguay's sheep and ewes are raised. Unlike anything most of the country's northern residents had ever experienced. I have never seen anything like it. And the people who have spent years working in the countryside haven't either. Not even their parents or their grandparents have told them stories like these. Nothing like this ever. Never has anyone ever heard of 3 days of rain, lethal winds, and drastic temperature changes, and the death of 30,000 sheep. This isn't good. When sheep, Christians are considered lambs, considered sheep. Even Jesus was called the Lamb of God who gave his life on the cross. Even Jesus told Peter, if you love me, feed my sheep, feed my lambs. What is going on? Something biblical is going on. Now, so I got two scriptures for you. First of all, I want you to go with me to the book of Hosea. Just for a moment, I know you know, many of you know the Hosea prophecy since the Lord revealed it to me and I shared it back when 5,000 blackbirds fell out of the sky and when, we had 2 million dead fish in Chesapeake Bay and 212 cows fell over dead and all of that. And the Lord showed me that this was the beginning of the Hosea prophecy, an ancient prophecy 3,000 years old that had never been fulfilled. And that the Lord told me as I was praying, said, Paul, it's going to continue to happen now until the coming of the Lord. So go ahead and prophesy it and preach it. It is the Hosea prophecy. Here's what the scripture says. Hear the word of the Lord, you children of Israel. For the Lord has a controversy with the inhabitants of the land. Because there's no truth, nor mercy, nor knowledge of God in the land, by swearing and lying and killing and stealing and committing adultery, they break out and blood touches blood. Therefore shall the land mourn, and everyone that dwelleth therein shall languish with the beast of the field, with the fowls of heaven, yea, and the fishes of the sea also shall be taken away. And of course, I wrote my very first book ever, called it the Hosea Prophecy. I was interviewed by CNN, by Fox News, Yahoo News, Time Magazine, all over. But this book here will help you understand what is the Hosea Prophecy. And you can find out all about it on our website at paulbegleyprophecy.com. Now, it's very important you understand this prophecy. But the Lord is speaking to me today about this event in Uruguay. I was saying, Lord, I know the Hosea Prophecy, but this is significant, isn't it? I didn't realize that it was in Uruguay back in April. I heard about sheep being genetically altered and sheep being born that were glowing in the dark, and I know that's not a good thing to do. I know it's not a good thing to do. Can I have a little more coffee? But go to the book of Jude. There is a spiritual significance to things that are taking place around the world. In the book of Jude, the Bible warns about evil, those that speak evil about the gospel. And it says in Jude verse 10, but these speak evil those things which they know not, but what they know naturally, as brute beasts, in those things they corrupt themselves. Woe unto them! For they have gone in the way of Cain and ran greedily after the heir of Balaam for a reward and perish in the gainsaying of Korah. Now, if you know these stories, Cain killed Abel. Balaam running after the greedily going after the doctrine of Balaam. And also those that died in the rebellion against Moses and Aaron in the when they were swallowed by the earth in Korah. The Lord says, these are spots in your feast of charity. When they feast with you, feeding themselves without fear. Now, those that feed you should be shepherds feeding the lambs. But instead of shepherds feeding the lambs, they feed themselves. They feed themselves without fear. Clouds they are without water, carried about with winds, trees whose fruit withereth. Without fruit they're twice dead, they're plucked up by the roots. Raging waves of the sea, foaming out their own shame. Wandering stars to whom is reserved the blackness of darkness forever. There is in the last days this gospel of being preached that gain is godliness. The Bible says, from such withdraw thyself, for godliness with contentment is great gain. Instead of feeding the lambs, they're feeding themselves, and they're following the way of Balaam. They're operating in the spirit of Cain, and they will perish in the same way as Korah. And what I want to say to you today, there's a definitely, if you don't believe in the apocalypse, you need to understand why in the world would 30,000 sheep die in Uruguay in 3 days? Are you serious? Something biblical is going on. The Hosea prophecy is being fulfilled, and the sin of mankind and the church needs to feed the lambs. Feed them the word of God. Don't be a little fluffy puffy preacher. Get in there and preach the truth. Lead them to Jesus. Let's put the altars back in the church. Let's put the crosses back on top the steeples. Let's preach repentance of sin. Let's baptize them in water. Let's let them be baptized in the Spirit of God. Let's lay hands on the sick that they may recover. Let's preach deliverance and set in spiritual blessings of the anointing of the power of God.